Yep, true that. Well, you and I had a conversation a bit earlier where you were telling me something about a brother who we both have a great appreciation of and a rather interesting story. I'll let you do the introduction.
Well, the thing is, Imhotep, you would think so long after King talked about equality all these years that there are still black folks that are being first, you know, the first black this, the first black, and our guest, Armand White, he is the first chairman, the first black person to chair the auspicious. And in his own words, he says it is the oldest, most prestigious critics organization in the world. It is the New York Film Critics Circle. He is a three-time chairman. He has chaired it 1994, 2009, and 2010. And last Monday, they had their 76th annual awards. And, you know, the people that won awards are just outstanding. I was even reading an article recently where I saw Armand White standing next to the Best Actress winner, and that's Annette Bening.
Oh, yeah.
And one of the reasons that I would like him to talk tonight is because I read somewhere, or I've been hearing a buzz, that he made Annette Bening cry at the event. I don't know how that came about, but I would really like Armand White to explain what happened. But first, I want to tell you a little bit about Armand White. He was the arts entertainment editor at the City Sun.
That's right.
We all respect that publication for what it was. He was the arts entertainment editor. He has taught a course called Men, Women, and Cinema, and he came on the show a few years ago talking about Michael Jackson, if you remember that.
Yes.
And for that, he won the 25th annual ASCAP Dean Taylor Award for Music Criticism when he did an essay called The Gloved One Is Not a Chump.
Mm-hmm. And that is I remember that piece.
Michael Jackson. His writing style is unique. As a matter of fact, some people say he's they call him contrarian. They say he's always contrary. But he is a provocative writer. And I am just happy to have him as a colleague. And I just want to welcome him this evening, Armand White, to the Global Beat Experience. Good evening, Armand.
Hey, good evening, Gunette. Good evening, Hotep.
My brother, evening. Good to have you with us tonight, as always.
I'm happy to talk to you all, as always. Too.
First of all, how did everything go on Monday night?
Well, for the people who were there, for most of the people who were there, I should say, it went beautifully. It was lovely. Annette Bening made a great speech about the need for criticism, the need for artists and critics to understand each other, and the need for the public to understand how artists and critics must work together.
Mm.
Beautiful speech. That part was lovely. The bad stuff came later, which is just the way that some people in the internet media chose to report on the evening. They didn't report on it well. They distorted it, told untruths about it, and that's what happened.
And some of the descriptions, are these from any of your 31 members in the critic circle?
Sorry to say, yes. Uh-huh. Yes. I don't think they're worth naming.
Okay.
But because there's, I guess you could say, there's dissension in the ranks, and it's kind of pitiful because, as you suggested before, you would think that the occasion of a black man heading the 76-year-old organization would be a sign that America's made some social progress. But then, as always, there are those people who want to show that progress is yet to be made, in fact.
So are there people challenging your chairmanship?
Yeah, but, you know, not challenging it in an upfront way, but simply challenging it in an underhanded and backstabbing way by misreporting what happened. Simply put, you talked about that internet rumor that I made Annette Bening cry. That's just false. And
Annette Bening did not cry.
Well, she cried because her award was presented to her by the actress Kerry Washington, who people might know from the Broadway play Race and also from several Spike Lee films, including The Miracle at St. Anna.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And She Hate Me. And Kerry Washington, who was Annette Bening's co-star in a movie called Mother and Child, presented the award to her. And Kerry Washington had really beautiful, complimentary things to say about Annette Bening. And upon hearing Kerry Washington's introduction, Annette Bening teared up.
Oh, she was surprised. She didn't know that she was going to present it to her.
Well, I think, well, she knew that, but she didn't know that what Kerry Washington
was
had
going
to say about her was
right.
going to be so, so moving and so genuine. And that's where the tears came from. But our tabloid, we're living in the tabloid media age, even when we're dealing with the Internet. So the tabloid media decided to say that I made her cry. I can only say for vicious racist reasons. But it's a lie. And it's a lie.
Oh, okay. And someone else that says it's a lie is the New York Press editor, Jerry Portwood.
Sure.
He, in an article that says, Connect the Dots, How to Criticize a Critic When He Doesn't Play the Game, says, I think it's shameful that people are concocting stories to take Armand White down, that there seems to be a campaign to crush his reputation as a great film lover, supporter, and thinker. Instead of reporting about what happened that evening, he's taking a pummeling for not playing the game by the industry's rules. Instead, he should be celebrated as someone who speaks truth to power, what most journalists should respect and cheer rather than jeer. And when I read that in the New York Press, I mean, that he says, speaking truth to power is something that you did at the City Sun.
That was the theme of the paper.
Yes,
I mean, my goodness.
You know, and that he used those words to really connect the dots is really poignant.
Well, you know, there is a God, because I'm happy to have the support of my editor, and I understand after all these years in journalism that not every writer gets that, but I got it, and it feels good to have it. But there's a God, because I didn't ask Jerry Portwood, my editor, to write that. Mm-hmm. He wrote that on his own. And the fact that he came up with the motto, Gary, the fact that he came up with the motto of the City Sun, beautiful to me.
Yes. Well, I'm thinking with the King that, you know, as he said, the arc of the moral universe is long, but it leans towards justice, bend towards justice.
Absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And I Vanette, I thank you for bringing it up and helping to clear the air on this bad stuff. But I'm also really, really happy to be able to say that they're trying to keep a black man down, but they're not going to crush me, because I learned to speak truth to power at the City Sun, at a black-owned newspaper, a paper that was owned and run by intelligent and courageous black folks. And that's part of my background. That's part of my grounding.
Yeah.
And that's not going to leave me.
Well,
no matter what other people say.
Well, Armand, how many black people are in the membership of the circle?
There are 31 members, and only two are black.
Only two.
So I'm surrounded by white folks. I'll say a plane. And it's really that fly in the buttermilk situation. I'm surrounded by, there are some good people there.
Have you made any effort to recruit more blacks to the membership?
Oh yes, I have indeed. And you know, we have a voting meeting every October for new members.
Uh-huh.
But I guess that here's more proof that there aren't enough good people in the group, because when black people do apply to get in the group, none has been elected since my election to the group in 1987. That's where we are today in liberal New York.
And in reality, how long can you serve as chairman before you have to step down?
Every chairmanship lasts 1 year.
Oh, so, 1 year, okay.
Yeah, this is my third year. And the chairman duties end at the night of the dinner, which the chairman is responsible for putting together.
But you've been voted, you've been approved three times.
Three times, sure.
Three times, my goodness.
So you must have
something's going on.
At least a fan base.
Exactly.
I've definitely got some supporters in the group. That's for sure.
Wow.
But the internet trouble is coming from a couple of members who you know, to paraphrase Kanye, they just don't like black people.
I'm sorry, but that is a reality that occurs. I would like you to speak to those people right now. Can you just tell them something? Because since you say you're not going anyplace, they're not going to crush you. But, you know, give them something to ponder over this holiday weekend.
Well, I would ask them to remember Dr. Martin Luther King's legacy. But also, I simply want them to remember the golden rule. Treat people the way you want to be treated.
Mm.
You know, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. And to realize, I gotta go here. Black people are here.
Mm.
And we're not leaving. And we're making advances. And we can run things, and we will do it, no matter who don't like it, no matter who's envious of it. And as just about everyone but the mean folks at that dinner can tell you, the dinner went beautifully. There are pictures on the internet of Annette Bening and I smiling together because she was happy. That's the truth of it. I think the evening went well. My chairmanship went well. I am the chairman who arranged for the New York Film Critics Circle to have their papers and records and documents put into an archive for the Museum of Modern Art that had never happened before.
I'm
the one who did that. I arranged for the group to have its own website, now an interactive, alive website. I was the first one to do that. I made a difference. There are racists who don't like it. I guess the thing to learn is that, you know, we're going to have to deal with racists all the time, but we will deal with them, and we will vanquish them.
I'm surprised because I've never heard you play the race card at any time, even in your reportage when you review things. I don't see you playing a race thing at all. So, you know,
I don't. But I would only go there when I feel it's absolutely necessary to.
Wow.
And this, you know, what's happened on the internet is so twisted and sick.
Well, one of the things that we might want to do, Armin, is in a reverse format, is actually put people in touch with you on the World Wide Web as we head towards our wrap-up.
Okay. Cool. I can be reached through the New York Press. The New York Press website, which is nypress.com. And that's a good way to read me and to reach me as well. And let people know what you think about what's happening. Let me know what you think of the articles I write, and support each other that way.
Well,
and a copy of this story, the editor's rebuttal is called Connect the Dots, How to Criticize a Critic When He Doesn't Play the Game, and it's at newyorkpress.com.
Yeah.
We give thanks, yeah.
So I thank you all for talking to me about this, and if I, a point I'd just like to underscore is that, you know, I'm blessed because I've got a background of conscious, courageous black people. And that's where I learned how to do what I do, and that's where I get my strength.
And that's that Andy Cooper spirit, brother. We know what that is.
Absolutely.
Give thanks. We appreciate you, Armin. Thanks so much.
All right. Thank you.
Hey, V. Wow. That was worthwhile and certainly important to do, and ironically, as they say, right on time.
Definitely.
Yeah.
King spirit.
Yeah. You know that. Give
thanks.
You. Appreciate you, sis.
Enjoy the rest of the weekend.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Take
bye-bye.
Care. And let's have Gary Bird's Global Beat Experience at 99.5 FM. WBAI, New York, where the message is in.